Today, we will talk about twin-engine deck-based fighter, or TEDBF. The TEDBF is designed and developed by the Aeronautical Development Agency with the Directorate of Naval Design and will be manufactured by Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. The TEDBF will replace the Mikoyan MiG-29K in Indian Navy service onboard the INS Vikramaditya and the INS Vikrant. The TEDBF is designed to perform all-weather multi-role missions including air-to-air combat, anti-ship strike, maritime strike, combat air patrol, escort jamming, buddy refueling, and land strike. Earlier it was planned Indian Navy will operate Naval AMCA from its third Katobar aircraft carrier and replace Mikoyan MiG-29K with foreign fighter jet, which was to be purchased under the multi-role carrier borne fighters deal. Multi-role carrier borne fighters or MRCB deal issued by the Indian Navy in 2016 for the acquisition of 57 multi-role deck-based fighters to operate from both the INS Vikramaditya and the INS Vikrant Stobar aircraft carrier. Due to the support of the Indian Air Force and Make in India, the Indian aviation industry developed rapidly in recent years. By early 2020, the Naval LCA had successfully carried out landing and takeoff on the aircraft carrier INS Vikramaditya. In April 2020, DRDO Aeronautical Development Agency announced that they are working on a new naval fighter jet according to the Indian Navy's MRCBF requirement floated in 2016 and the new naval fighter unveiled at the Aero India 2021 turned out to be an entirely new design. DIADA is expecting the TEDBF research and development program cost will be 13,000 crores rupees, out of which 60% will come from the government and 40% from the Navy's budget. First prototype of TEDBF will be rolled out by 2025, followed by its first flight in 2026. As per some reports, the Indian Navy will acquire 100 units of TEDBF for 3 aircraft carriers. The TEDBF is designed with diamond-shaped tailless delta wings with leading-edge extension and close-coupled canard to increase lift and maneuverability, and a vertical stabilator. Flight control surfaces include flaps, ailerons, rudders, vertical stabilizers, and all-moving canards. These canards also serve as air brakes. The flight control surfaces will be controlled by a central management computer system. TEDBF will have a digital fly-by-wire control system. To reduce radar cross-section, TEDBF will have a diamond-shaped design, composites material airframe, radar absorbent paint, and S-shaped air intakes to reduce radar exposure to the fan blade. TEDBF measures 16.30 meter in length, 11.20 meter in wingspan in unfolded condition, and 7.6 meter wingspan in folded condition. TEDBF will have a maximum takeoff weight of 26,000 kilograms, including 12,000 kilograms to 13,000 kilograms of empty weight, 7,000 kilograms of payload, and 6,000 kilograms of internal fuel carrying capacity. TEDBF can attain maximum speed up to Mach 1.6. If we compare engine thrusts and weight, TEDBF could actually achieve a maximum speed of Mach 2 and also would be able to supercruise at speeds of around Mach 1.5 or more. The service ceiling of TEDBF is 18,000 meters or 60,000 feet. The TEDBF will have 13 hardpoints with a carrying capacity of around 7 tons. The aircraft is capable of withstanding from minus 3G to 8G. The TEDBF is to be powered by two 110 kN thrust class afterburning turbofan engines mounted side by side in the fuselage, fed by diverterless supersonic inlets. The TEDBF prototype will be powered by GF414 afterburning turbofan engine, and the production variant will be powered by indigenous 110 kN thrust class afterburning turbofan engines. It is expected that the foreign partner for the joint development of a 110 kN thrust class engine will be announced at the Defence Expo 2022, and the agreement for the joint venture will be signed in the second half of 2022. For enhanced man-machine interaction, the TEDBF will have an artificial intelligence glass cockpit equipped with a wide panoramic touchscreen display, a multifunction display, and a wide-angle holographic head-up display. The TEDBF will have a hands-on throttle and stick arrangement on the right hand and engine throttle settings on the left-hand side. TEDBF will have a larger and powerful variant of the Uttam ESA radar based on gallium nitride technology. To increase situational awareness, TEDBF will have 360-degree distributed passive sensors and multi-sensor data fusion with artificial intelligence. For electronics warfare, TEDBF will have an advanced electronic warfare suite to perform both countermeasures and counter-countermeasures. Three prototypes of TEDBF will be manufactured by HAL. First prototype will conduct its first flight in 2026. In the first prototype, ADA and the Indian Navy will test its digital fly-by-wire control system and flight characteristics. Second prototype will conduct its first flight in 2027. In the second prototype, ADA and the Indian Navy will conduct weapon trials and avionics trials. Both prototype testing will be carried out from a shore-based facility. Third prototype will conduct its first flight in 2028. In the third prototype, ADA and the Indian Navy will conduct testing from an aircraft carrier. The TEDBF will enter Indian Navy services in 2032.